What is up, my birdies? I'm finally back with a new video, and this time I got a commission for two pop customs. It's Skinny Jasper and Canalion from Steven Universe. And this is gonna be a very extensive tutorial, because these two were really challenging. So I'm gonna split this video up in two parts. In the first part, I'm gonna show you how to make Skinny Jasper, and in the second one, we make Canalion. Let's do this. Okay, first we're gonna need a base for the figure. Usually I would use the female pop blank. The only problem is she's not skinny enough for skinny, because skinny is really skinny. But I do have a skinny pop figure, and that's Pearl. And last time I checked, she was the skinniest figure available. So my idea is to do a little shapeshifting again, even though I promised Garnet not to do so anymore.
Sorry, Garnet.
Okay, we're done.
So, if you ever had a Pearl pop figure, you may know that they tip over very easily. And since Skinny Jasper's head is a lot heavier than Pearl's, she will stand up even worse, so I have to think about something to fix this. Also, if you compare the sizes of the two, you know Skinny is a lot taller than Canalion. And this is why I need to stretch the figure. And by figure, I mean the whole body, the arms and the legs. And the first step to do this is to disassemble these babies, which I'm not gonna show on camera. There we go, and I have to say, Pearl was kind of a challenge, because these two parts are really hard to disassemble. This literally took me forever. Now I'm preparing Skinny's gem, and for this I found this beautiful glass bead. You may remember them from bracelets they had in the 90s, but they are still available. I found a store who sells them individually, and I got one. I just had to use my drill to make the hole a little bigger, so this wire can fit through. And I bended the wire so that the bead is at an angle, and this gives this nice diagonal reflection we are going for. And the plan is to take this contraption and put it somewhere in between Pearl's chest and her waist. And this is where Skinny's belly button is going to be. So when the gem is inserted, the figure will automatically be stretched to Skinny's body size. Here's a handy tip. If you ever need to cut the pop material, you will have a hard time, because it's very durable vinyl material. And the trick is to bring in some heat. You can do this with hot water. I'm just using my heat gun for convenience, and hold it on for a few seconds until the plastic gets soft. But don't do this for too long, or the plastic will burn. Okay, so after cutting, this is what I have. I drilled already some holes into the body and put some wire through it. And I'm using Pearl's actual hands for the figure, because you know they are very, very difficult to sculpt, especially in this size. Here's the wire with the gem. I put it in the middle of the body, and you see it has this beautiful reflection to it in this diagonal pattern which we want. When I sculpt the figure later, I add the clay in such a way that you can see the gem from the front. And next thing I do is to bring the legs in shape. So, quick update. After bending everything into shape, this is what I have now. The legs are not yet quite what I expected. And the hands, hang down a little, because they're out of balance. Skinny should hold her arm like this here, but the clay will hold everything in place later. This is the size Skinny Jasper will have later, and I'm gonna sculpt it without the head first, because the head is very, very heavy and it's almost impossible to bake without tipping over. This here is a prototype of Canalion's body, and it helps me to make the skinny figure the right size so it can lean on it later. This is just a quick assembly of Canalion's body parts and some reusable clay. Alright, let's start with the sculpting. I got my Fimo Professional, which I'm always using, and I just kneaded it to make it soft. And to get it even more softer and more sticky, I'm using Fimo Liquid. This stuff gets crystal clear when you bake it, but you can also use it to make Fimo more sticky. If you can't get the stuff where you live, just use Bake and Bond from Sculpey instead, and it will work just as fine. I'm not gonna use the sticky Fimo to sculpt the body, it's actually for filling these gaps where the wire comes out. And this will hold the wire in place and stabilize the whole figure. There's really not much to it, I just rip off tiny bits from the clay, put it inside the gaps and push it into place with my modeling tools. When it's done, the wire should be stabilized and not come out anymore, so I can finally concentrate on sculpting the belly. I'm using the back of my pocket knife to get the surface of the clay as smooth as possible. Quick update guys, I sculpted the legs. They are much thicker than they are supposed to be because I want to file them down after baking, which is much easier than sculpting them really really thin from the beginning. For now, I'm continuing with the arms. Okay, the sculpting is pretty much done, and this is what I have. I noticed her chest has rotated a little, but I fixed this in a minute. I managed it to make the arms really, really thin. I hope it's not too thin. Maybe I add a little more clay to those, so just to reinforce it a little. I'm not gonna smooth this out any further at this point, because I'm really happy how the figure turned out, and I don't want to waste it. So this goes in the oven for about 30 minutes at 110 degrees Celsius. As you can see, the body is balanced out pretty well. I can lean it on my Olaf coffee mug, so it can bake standing upright. After cooling down, you can see the gem is completely baked in. It still has this beautiful reflection. And now that the body is solid and rigid, we can finally start the sanding and make the surface as smooth as possible. In order to transform all of the edges to a smooth transition, I'm gonna use my X-Acto knife. This is a great tool for cutting femur, but be careful because it's really, really sharp. To get rid of all the cutting marks, I'm using my Dremel. And this is what I got after removing all the cutting marks and sanding everything down with sandpaper. The gem looks awesome, it's polished, the arms and legs are completely straight, the backside is good, transitions are smooth, so the next step would be to give the figure a base color. But before I do this, I'm gonna take care of the head, and in the meantime, I can lean my skinny Jasper body to my coffee mug. So far, the balancing of the body works really great. I hope this is still the case when the head is done. I'm not gonna use Pearl's head for customizing because there's so much I have to modify, like the nose, the gem, the hair in the face, and also the shape of her head, which is way too different from what I need for skinny. Instead, I'm using this head from another Pop DIY, which I had lying around. Now the goal is to sculpt this head in such a way that when you put it back on the body, the whole figure is still balanced. And this is gonna be a little of a challenge because the head will get very heavy from the clay. And from my experience, the hair always takes a lot of femur, so we use the big block. Okay, this is what I started with. I made the sides and the front, and it's nothing spectacular, just making little spikes of clay, roll it with the fingers and then put it on the back of the head. And basically, you do this until the whole head is covered. Just make sure to alternate between the shapes of the spikes, so make bigger ones, make smaller ones. Just make the hair as wild as you can. Okay, after sculpting for a little time, this is what I have. As you can see, all of the spots have been covered with hair, and I tried to give her kind of a haircut. Yeah, I'm gonna make some more strands here in the front, which are going to hang in her face, and then this whole thing goes in the oven to bake. Okay, after baking, everything should be ready. I have my skinny body here, and the head and the hair. I actually had to disassemble the head again and put a giant brass screw in it because the hair is so heavy that it pulls the figure back, and the screw in the front will help canceling this out. And yes, this makes the head very heavy, but since the weight is distributed, it should be okay. At least I've been testing it 5 minutes ago and she was balanced. Okay, I think we're ready to paint, and I start with the face. But before I do this, I wanna make sure that I don't paint any areas where the glue is gonna go later. Because to achieve the best adhesion, I want the glue to make a direct contact between the vinyl material and the Fimo. I put the hair back in place, and I'm using a yellow marker to trace the outlines. I'm using yellow because the orange color of the head will cover it up nicely, so the contour won't be visible later. Okay, first I'm gonna paint on a few layers of orange base color. Next, I'm making Skinny's skin drawing, and for this I'm using a more reddish color. And from the picture I see that the line goes from around here, all over the face, over the nose, and over the right eye, to approximately this point here. And now I can use this line as an orientation and paint the upper half of the face in red. Alright. It's not perfect, but I'm gonna let this dry for a few minutes and then touch it up. Okay, next I wanna do the eyes, and I have to set up the head somehow so it doesn't fall over, because the screw is very heavy and it would make the head always fall on the painted side. So I'm gonna use my pliers, stick it right through here, and this makes a nice support. The head is steady and can't move anymore. You can make the eyes any color you like. My customer wanted black, so I'm using black paint and draw some half open eyes. If you're not happy with the design or made some mistakes doing painting, just wait for the black paint to dry completely and then cover it up with a little bit of white. What the white does, it cancels out the darkness of the black, and it's much easier to cover up again with fresh paint. When you're done with the eyes, it's time to do the eyebrows. I'm just using a darker shade of red. Make the eyebrows as alike as you can, but remember, eyebrows are like sisters, not like twins. And no, I haven't done a makeup tutorial yet, and I probably never will. Last thing is to draw the mouth, and for this I have my ink pens, which I usually use for drawing. I don't recommend them using on acrylic paint, because the pen may get clogged. But in this case, it's much easier than using a paintbrush. Here's a handy tip, if you ever need to paint fine structures like this, make a sketch with a pencil first, because on the acrylic paint you can erase just like on paper, and then trace it with the pen. It's very good if you have a steady hand, because this is tricky. This is really tricky, but don't worry, you can always touch it up later, just like we did with the eyes. Technically, the hair doesn't need to be painted, since the femur is white already. But I had to use the glue a few times, so it's a good idea to give everything a uniform color again. Speaking of color, I added a tiny little drop of yellow to the white, just to make the tone a little warmer. But this is optional, you can also use the plain white straight from the can if you prefer this. Now when I started painting the body, I noticed that I forgot to sculpt the cleavage of a dress. So what I did is to get my Dremel and just cut out a little V-shape. And before getting back to her dress, I drew the skin color first. Keep in mind that you sometimes have to do multiple layers until you get a uniform coverage. Alright, now that's done, so let's get back to the chest. Okay, as you can see, I messed up the paint job here a little because I got my finger into the skin color, but never mind, I can touch it up with white and then put on skin color again. For the diamond, I mixed some light blue color with a little bit of white, and this helps cover up the dark paint better. For the pattern on her arm, I used the same shade of red as I did for the face. Again, I'm using my ink pen to draw the contours, and again, it's not recommended to do it. Wonderful, now that everything is painted and lacquered, we can finally assemble the custom. And for this, I mixed up some epoxy glue. Make sure you mix it thoroughly, and then apply it to the adapter piece where the neck is gonna get in. Now, this is not an original piece from a pop figure, this is actually a piece I customized with my 3D printer, because I need the hole to be off-center, this is important for keeping the figure in balance. Use a paper towel so you won't smudge your fingers, and then push the piece in firmly. Okay, now I'm gluing the head back together, I mixed up some more epoxy glue, and I'm just distributing it on the area which I left unpainted. Put the head back together and make sure that the hair is covering all of the holes and gaps and everything which was necessary to get the head in balance. Looking good from here? No gaps, no holes? Wonderful! Last but not least, you insert the body back into the head. You can see everything remains perfectly movable. Skinny has a nice glossy finish to it, and at this point, she's done! I wanna give a big thank you to Tess Cortez for commissioning these figures. If you don't know her, she's an awesome artist who really loves drawing and of course Steven Universe. If you do too, please click here to visit her channel and please leave her a like and subscribe. Thank you so much for watching everybody, I really appreciate it. Click here to watch the video of Canalian and click here to watch one random video from my channel. I love you, I see you next time, bye!